Sweetheart,
it is going good. It's even better now. I'm sitting here talking to you.
Likewise.
Look at you. I love it. So from your Tony nominated role in Ghost, mm-hmm. to Dolemite, mm-hmm. to The Holdovers, how does it feel for you to be able to inhabit a role of a black woman where she is simply that, a fully fleshed out human being?
Thank you God, finally. You know, I'm very grateful for that. When I read the script, it was the first thing I was like, oh, okay. You can fill me in on the details later, but I'm in. For that sole purpose. Because as you know, these opportunities are so far and few in between. And then on top of it, to do such at this level, right?
Mm-hmm.
We have certain outlets. I'm not going to list them, but we have certain outlets where we can do our work, but the quality is questionable. However, when there is the opportunity to be in my skin, not having to be at service to someone in order for my story to be necessary, it was worth it. It was worth the fight. It was worth sticking in it. It was worth it. And I hope that this will not only open doors for myself, but more importantly, others, so that we can see, yep, it works. Keep doing it.
Oh, yeah, girl, you didn't drop kick the door down. But anywho.
Thank you.
There's a quote that Paul has in the movie where he says, history is not simply a study of the past, but an explanation of the present. Mm-hmm. So having said that, did you have a professor in college that made you kind of like, get really deep and get you out of your own way?
Yeah, I would say it, while I was at Yale School of Drama, it was the head of the acting department, Ron Van Loo, who I actually called him and told him that when I got this part, and I was like, I know you're not my teacher no more, but we doing text analysis. Let me know when you're available. And he graciously made time for me. He was just someone I would go to hit in my class. I was the only black female in my class. Mm. And we had two guys. That was it. No other black people were in our class. And I would go to him every 2 weeks and be like, why is everybody playing, you know, Yelena and I'm playing Masha? You know what I mean? Or why is everybody playing Nora in Doll's House and I'm playing the old lady Miss Schmidt? Like, what's going on? So I've always, at a very, very young age, always in regards to types and how black women are portrayed or how the roles are portrayed through this body has always been a very, very important thing to me and something that I have fought for, and I seek for the details. So, like, you'll get this. Her hair, her work hair and that bun, that's from Wheezy. Jefferson's first season, because remember in the beginning, she wasn't used to the wealth yet. So she was still rocking that like working class blue collar bun. That flip, that's Maxine in the Jeffersons.
Oh.
Also with when she has the dinner party look, that's Phyllis Hyman off of the cover where she has the orange like caftan that crosses.
Oh, I know. I was her publicist.
The orange one with the feathers up and she has it up in the...
Look at you.
But I always do that in all of my roles. But especially in this one because it was a period piece. But I also leaned into it more with working with Ruth Carter, obviously with Dolemite.
Mm.
That she was like, yeah, this is an opportunity to pay homage whenever we can. And so I did a little bit before, but she really encouraged me to dig in further. So I'm always finding tropes and women from history to plug in, almost like subliminal messages, so that people understand it's nothing new under the sun and give props where it's due.
I understand that about you. I appreciate that about
you.
And I just appreciate you as an artist, as a person.
Thank you,
sis, for giving me your time today. I
Absolutely.
Really, really love that you did that.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate that.